Note to self, don't leave the keys to my creepy evil spirit room lying around. Hey everybody, welcome to Mainly Movies. Today we're going to be continuing my Conjuring Universe review series with the 2019 supernatural horror sequel, Annabelle Comes Home. If you're new here, please consider subscribing for a variety of movie-related content like reviews, ranked lists, and trailer reactions. All my reviews include a breakdown of the pros and cons, my rating, and some tailored film recommendations, so be sure to watch through to the end of this video for all of that extra content. Annabelle Comes Home stars McKenna Grace, Madison Eisman, and Katie Serafe, and was directed by longtime Conjuring Universe writer Gary Dauberman. It tells the story of Judy Warren, who, along with her babysitter and babysitter's friend, gets trapped in a haunted house of sorts when the evil spirits contained within her parents' artifact room are released. It seems like you never really know what you're gonna get from a Conjuring Universe film. The core Conjuring movies have all been really good, but the spin-offs have been frustratingly inconsistent, both in terms of quality and also of tone. And of the spin-offs, the Annabelle subseries has gotta be the worst offender. The first Annabelle was pretty disappointing, coming on the heels of The Conjuring, but Annabelle Creation was surprisingly good, and I'd say the most effective spin-off in terms of the scares. So going into this third Annabelle movie, I really didn't know which of the two types of films to expect. And it turns out, neither. Annabelle Comes Home is unlike any of the spin-offs we've seen so far. Since this is the third film in the sub-series, it's not an origin story. We already know what the deal is with Annabelle, so the movie doesn't have to spend any time digging into the lore. Another thing that makes this spin-off unique is the sheer number of interconnections it has with the rest of the Conjuring universe. I thought Annabelle Creation had done a pretty good job with its links to other universe films, and they all have some connection, but after the most tenuously connected movie, in the case of The Curse of La Llorona, we've got our most strongly connected, by far. This is the only one of the spin-offs to actually feature Ed and Lorraine Warren, or at least new footage of them. Granted, they're not in this film all that much, but their presence has a definite impact and adds a little more legitimacy, if you will, to the movie. But Ed and Lorraine aren't the only connection here. This movie is almost exclusively set in their house and prominently features their artifact room. So not only do we get to see items that we're already familiar with, like the mirror music box from The Conjuring, but we're also introduced to a ton of other items, which will likely eventually get their own spin-offs. And if all of that wasn't enough to make this movie unlike any of the other spin-offs, we've also got the very different tone. Prior to 2019, all of the movies in the Conjuring universe were quite self-serious in their approach to the stories. This worked really well in the core films and Annabelle Creation, but less so in the first Annabelle movie and The Nun. 2019 gave us two Conjuring Universe films, and they each stepped away from the serious, purely horror tone. The Curse of La Llorona played out more like a mystery thriller than a truly scary movie. Annabelle Comes Home certainly plays out like a horror film, but it loses that weighty seriousness of its predecessors. And so rather than scoffing at how not scary it is, it becomes a film that you can enjoy and have fun with. By incorporating the artifact room, the sky was the limit with what could happen here. And so instead of just having one demon or scary antagonist, this movie utilizes quite a few. Various evil spirits escape from the artifact room and spread out through the Warrens' house to create literally a haunted house. And so we end up seeing our young protagonists get terrorized in a number of different ways. And I think that variety helps this movie, because not only do we have a lot of interesting new monsters to contend with, but we also get an assortment of scare styles as well. There are quite a few cheap jump scares here, but there were also a lot of jump scares that are earned and used very effectively too. And we've also got some moments of tense atmospheric horror that's more akin to the core Conjuring films. Much like Annabelle Creation, this movie focuses in on pretty young characters, except they end up being entirely on their own here. And I think this setup has some positives and negatives. Initially, this movie seems like it's going to be sort of a typical teen horror movie, but it evolves into something different. By focusing on Judy Warren, Ed and Lorraine's daughter, we get a different perspective. This is a character who knows all about her parents' work and has grown up immersed in this creepy stuff. So finding Annabelle staring at her from under the couch, something that would terrify me, barely phases her. Our other two main characters don't exactly make the best decisions, which is certainly very frustrating at points in this movie, but amazingly, as the story develops, they aren't nearly as annoying as you'd think they'd be. And of course, since this is a Conjuring Universe film, I have to talk about the cinematography here. As was the case with the majority of these movies, it's really good. The more tense, atmospheric build-up moments are the best for this, but it's a very visually interesting movie throughout. The framing of shots and what's in or out of focus in a particular scene is extremely important for building up to the scares, and was key for making some of the jump scares actually feel earned and satisfying. And of course, this is another 70s set movie, which this franchise has always done an excellent job with capturing. The diegetic music is awesome, this time extensively featuring Day After Day by Badfinger, and once again, this movie just feels of its time period. Alright, let's talk about the pros and cons. Pro number one has got to be all of the connections to other Conjuring Universe films. Of the spin-offs, this is the one that feels the most closely associated to the first Conjuring film. There are some obvious direct connections there, like the fact that this film picks up right where the Annabelle opening of The Conjuring ended, but featuring characters like Ed, Lorraine, and Judy Warren, as well as setting the story in their house and artifact room, helped to bring it all together as well. We see items that are prominently featured in other movies, like Annabelle and Rory's music mirror box, but we also get some more time with items that have only briefly appeared in the artifact room scenes from the other movies. And with this movie taking place before The Conjuring 2, it also does a good job of touching on the public persona issues the Warrens faced, and nicely segues into the hoax theme of the second Conjuring film. Pro number two is the creepiness. Despite taking on a slightly different tone than any of the other Universe movies, I think the variety of supernatural things seen in this film offer a lot of creepy moments. We see poltergeist activity, possession, many practical effects creatures, several ghosts, a surprisingly unsettling board game, and of course, the Annabelle doll simply existing and showing up randomly around the house, which is creepy enough. As has been the case with all of the spin-offs, I would not consider this movie to be scary, but I do think, again, taking its differing tone into account, it's one of the more effective spin-offs in terms of scares, and definitely the most fun. On the con side, the biggest issue has got to be the dumb character decisions. Kids in horror movies aren't exactly known for being the smartest, and to be fair, there's only one character whose actions are consistently frustrating here. Daniela makes some horrible decisions in this movie. There are a few scenes here where you want to yell at the screen and tell her to just stop what she's doing. But without these actions, we wouldn't have had a movie. And as the film progresses, we do get some explanation for her actions. It doesn't make them any less frustrating, but at least it provides some helpful context. Before I give you my rating and recommendations, I want to remind you that if you're interested in buying Annabelle Comes Home or any of the films I mentioned today, I do have affiliate links for all of them in the description below. I get a small commission from anything you buy using one of my links, so I'd really appreciate it if you use them if you're in the market for any of these movies. I'm gonna give Annabelle Comes Home 3.5 out of 5 paws. I really didn't expect much going into this movie, but ended up enjoying it quite a bit. It's a little different from any of the other Conjuring Universe films, but was actually quite fun and had a lot of genuinely creepy moments. I would recommend Annabelle Comes Home to people who like the Warrens and the broader expansiveness of the Conjuring Universe. If you're looking for a scary, atmospheric horror like the first Conjuring movie, you're gonna be disappointed by this. But if you want to spend a fun few hours in the Warrens' house being tracked down by an assortment of evil supernatural artifact room escapees, then you're gonna have a creepy blast with this, and probably get excited about the prospect of a few other spin-offs. If you liked Annabelle Comes Home, I've gotta recommend 13 Ghosts, the 2001 remake. It's another haunted house movie featuring a number of unique, spooky antagonists, each with their own scare MO. That's another movie with a lot of creepy moments that somehow still manages to be very fun. If you like the intro with the Warrens, I definitely suggest you check out The Conjuring. Not only do you get a bit more of that Annabelle opening, but you spend a lot more time with the Warrens in a tense, atmospheric horror film. And if you want some more Annabelle, you might want to watch the second Annabelle movie, Annabelle Creation. creation. It's another one that's genuinely creepy and shows the doll's origins, which provides a little more context for certain things in this film. Alright, a couple questions for you guys. Number one, have you seen Annabelle Comes Home? If so, what'd you think of it? And number two, which of the evil spirits or possessed items shown in this movie would you like to see get its own spin-off? Be sure to leave your answers in the comments below so we can get a discussion going. Alright, so if you got some enjoyment, insider information out of this review, I'd appreciate it if you'd hit that like button. And if you haven't done so already, please hit subscribe or add it to see more videos like this. Till next time, this has been Alyssa with Mainly Movies, the way life should be.